the way political endorsements work, happen behind the scenes, is normally that the current candidates will normally ask for them. They'll approach high-profile leaders and politicians personally and ask for their endorsements. Same thing goes for political groups like Emily's List or NARAL, unions like WEAC or the local pipe fitters, professional groups like, you know, the Chamber of Commerce or the Pro Bowlers Association, whatever. When it comes to business groups, some groups decide to give endorsements every single cycle. Some do not. Some groups will occasionally give endorsements if their member board is a strong preference one way or another. Some will never give endorsements. And then there's the question of, will you endorse in the primaries or only in the general elections? Well, Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, from what I know, almost never endorses in the primaries. I've learned that it's going to make an exception this fall in the Wisconsin governor's race, and joining me to talk about it is president of WMC, Kurt Bauer. Good morning, sir. How are you?
I'm good, Jay. How are you?
Good. Do I have the basics correct? It's rare for the WMC to endorse in a primary. Who will you be endorsing?
It's not unprecedented, but yeah, it's rare. The last time it happened was in the 2010 race where we selected Walker.
Okay, so who are you endorsing in this gubernatorial race?
Rebecca Clayfish. So there's some symmetry there because, of course, Walker ran with Clayfish.
Mm-hmm. Why Rebecca Clayfish and why in the primaries? We have some guys that are still considering getting into this race.
Well, I was on your show a month ago talking about our Wisconsin 2035 plan, and that plan outlines a variety of systemic challenges the state has, from, you know, the test proficiency for K-12 that are falling behind, the workforce shortages, the fact that we are dropping in many of the key economic competitive metrics. We need to do something about that, and we believe that Rebecca Clayfish is the right leader at the right time to address those challenges. Her 1848 project that she was running prior to announcing actually was on a parallel track with us. We were doing meetings with key business leaders, other stakeholders around the state, and she was doing something very similar, and she was hearing very similar things that we were hearing. So there's a lot of alignment with what we see are the major problems facing the state and some of the solutions to address them.
Well, I think you'd agree that with me that it's still very early in the primary season. So if WMC board members normally sort of hold their powder in primaries, why not wait to see what Kevin Nicholson or Eric Hovde or, you know, Tommy Thompson might have to offer?
I think the key thing is that this is an important race. She has a major head start. She's done the hard work. She's been going around the state with that 1848 project. And then as a candidate, she's been getting the key endorsements, getting the supporters, raising money. She's done the hard work. She's ahead of the curve.
Yeah, we're talking with Kurt Bauer of Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce. I've sort of talked about this on my show. The Clayfish campaign has been trying to build a case to potential challengers that her nomination is a fait accompli. They've been doing it with big fundraising numbers, with locking in and rolling out big endorsements like this one. They'll rush to tout WMC's endorsements today, I'm sure. So I have to read this as the WMC board members not wanting to see a brutal primary on the Republican side of the aisle this year either. Would I be sort of correct in that assumption?
Yeah, and you know, we're going to have a very important U.S. Senate race, and there are estimates that that race could cost as much as $200 million just for the Senate race. That will choke off a lot of attention, and a bruising primary for the gubernatorial race just puts us that puts us at a disadvantage. We think that we need reform, and we need it starting in 2023 when the new legislature comes in. Rebecca Clayfish is the right person to lead those reform efforts.
WMC, the Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, was not designed to be a partisan organization, and you try not to be. I know I've talked with you multiple times about this. You've come to be known as a conservative group simply because the Democrat Party has become known as the anti-business party, and the Republican party has been known as the pro-business party. So the early endorsement here, is it also an indication that your members are saying Governor Evers has been bad for business in the Wisconsin economy? Would that be accurate?
Yeah, that's fair. I mean, we're not a conservative organization. We're a pro-business organization. We make no apologies for that. But the Evers record shows that he's out of touch. In particular on workforce, I mean, we're talking about just ignoring the issue. It's stunning and inexcusable. I've been on your show in the past talking about how he's tried to raise taxes. higher energy costs. He wanted to repeal Act 10, repeal right to work. He's taking us backwards, and we need someone to take us forward.
We're talking with Kurt Bauer, the president of Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce. I'd like to move on to a few other things, including the fact that Wisconsin's unemployment rate is back down to an impressive 2.8%, and yet Wisconsin businesses are still clamoring for workers. That figure is misleading because it doesn't factor in the overall participation rate, correct? I mean, we still have a lot of people not rejoining the workforce.
You're exactly right. So our labor participation rate pre-COVID was top five, but it was still only about 70%. It's now much lower than that. We haven't rebounded to pre-COVID numbers on the labor participation rate, and every percentage point on the labor participation rate is about 40, 45,000 workers. We've got to get people back into the labor force, and part of the problem was is we were incentivizing people not to work. I've talked about that on your show in the past, and of course, Governor Evers didn't help us with that. He did not eliminate that $300 per week supplemental that was included in the American Rescue Plan by the Biden administration. So this goes back to the endorsement. I mean, this is a major problem for the state. If we don't have the workers, we lose the jobs, we lose the tax revenue, all the economic activity that goes with it. This is the fundamental problem the state is facing, and Governor Evers isn't addressing it.
Yeah. You're talking to your members. You know what's going on the ground. So do we believe that the people who were working before the COVID shutdown and are now still on the sidelines, do we think they are mostly retirees who won't be back, or are they reluctant workers who eventually will be, or what?
It's a good question, and I don't really have the answer to that. Yes, we saw an uptick in retirements. We've got some people who are still concerned about going back to work with COVID still out there, which is a real problem for us. I mean, some people can work from home. You can't do that in manufacturing. You can't do that in agriculture. You can't do that in the tourist economy, which, of course, those are three pillars of the Wisconsin economy. We need people to show up for work. So the real problem from our perspective is that we just don't have enough people. Obviously, we've got to retain as much talent as we possibly can in the state, but we're going to have to be additive. We need people to come to Wisconsin.
Does WMC support the changes that Republican lawmakers were talking about in Madison last week? One of them puts a length of Wisconsin unemployment benefits on a sliding scale depending on the availability of jobs. Is that something your group would support?
We like very much what the legislature is doing in that regard, and we very much appreciate them taking proactive steps to try and address this problem. They understand it's a big problem. They understand the consequences if we don't solve it, so we appreciate their efforts.
And again, it's a matter of getting it past Tony Evers. They could pass that, and will pass that legislation today, and he would veto it, so it gets us right back to the endorsement. Anything else to add before I let you go here?
No, I appreciate the time. Obviously, this is going to be an important race. It will have a national component to it. We're told that next to Kansas, this is the number one target. Cook Political Report has it as a toss-up. So there's a real opportunity for the state of Wisconsin to get back into a reform mode with Rebecca Clayfish, and WMC hopes that that happens.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your time this morning, sir. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Jay.
It is Kurt Bauer, the president of Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, giving me an early exclusive here on a rare primary endorsement. It's not unprecedented, but it is a rare primary endorsement from Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce. They're endorsing Rebecca Clayfish for governor in the Republican primary, and you heard the reasoning. They believe she's way out in front. She's worked very hard to crisscross the state, get endorsements. She worked very well with WMC specifically, bringing jobs to Wisconsin during the Walker era, and they don't want an ugly knockdown, drag down primary fight. So that's interesting news today from Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce. It is.